Welcome back to Sawen, Aorihwa. Now, we have a couple of community issues to talk about, but we have this brand new feature.
It's very important issue.
It's so important.
Yes.
Hey, listen, we have a part of the show that we're calling The Crank, and this is what we're going to do, okay? First of all, we have this phone. Second of all, we are going to take a number from the phone book. We're going to ask you a skill testing question. But here's the cool thing. You're going to win a package of four tickets to Cinema Carnival.
In Chattagay,
the movie theater in Chattagay. All right, so here we go.
So we're just randomly going to dial anybody's number.
Yeah, we're not going to say any names until...
Okay.
So that one. Okay.
450-63...
We can't say the number. Yeah, there you go.
Everybody has a day.
555-5555. There you go. We got a good level? Yeah, we're good? All right. I don't know how to use a phone.
Okay.
I hit four twice. Hold on. Man. I don't work a phone either. Okay.
What question are we asking?
Who won the game last night? What was the score? Hockey game. Maybe I have it here. Actually,
they don't.
Oh, they may. Who knows?
Hello?
Maybe they're shopping. Yeah, this is a winner, Regan.
Not available now.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. We may have to block our number. People see, like, Loud Spirit Productions calling and they think, uh-oh, television, I'm in trouble.
Maybe that's when they're not answering. Who knows? Okay, who am I talking to? I'm just going to press this. All right.
Okay, hold on.
Yeah, we're doing well with this. All right.
All right. I can feel it. This is gonna be it.
Yeah. Right then.
No.
No.
Okay.
There we go.
All right. There got to be somebody home here.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi, can I speak to Vanessa, please?
It's Vanessa.
Hi, Vanessa. It's Lance and Regan from Sawen, Aorihwa. How are you today?
Busy.
I bet you are. You guys want to win a package of four to Cinema Carnival tickets?
Well, could you call me back, or this is my last chance?
This is your chance, Vanessa. It's going to take 2 seconds.
What is it? Oh, tonight? Okay.
Okay, so what was the score from last night's hockey game? Between Canada and Norway.
Oh my god, and Gum watched it. Am I allowed to ask Gum?
Go ahead.
Gum, what was the score last night? The hockey team that played. Oh wow, 8-0.
What's that?
8-0.
You are right.
Congratulations.
You are right, Vanessa. You and your whole family are winning tickets to Cinema Carnival movie theater in Chattagay.
Okay, they love to go to movies like this. Okay.
And you're on the air, by the way.
So, okay. So you can come pass by over here anytime.
Okay, now we're live.
Okay,
thanks,
Anna.
Okay.
Anna. Anna. We'll be
so
back
we
after this, perhaps.
We got it.
Yeah, we did get
her.
Yeah, we got it.
We got
so,
her.
Good
so
stuff.
She won the tickets.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't think she knew she was on air.
I don't think so. But anyway, congratulations to
Vanessa
Rice. And she won herself a package of four tickets to Cinema Carnival.
Yes.
We have a lot. We have a bunch. We're going to be doing this.
We're going to be calling people.
Exactly.
You may get a call from us.
There you go.
Expect it.
Random phone book.
Yes.
It's called The Crank.
Oh my God, that was so fun. Anyways, so look forward to The Crank. You may be getting a call from our studio.
Yeah, absolutely. And a new fire truck is here in town. But more importantly, somebody brave the brand new fire truck and pretty proud of you. She actually
could. I did.
Here's the thing. She calls me yesterday and she's like, hello, Lance. I'm like, hey, how are you? There's a new fire truck in town. I said, this is great. And she goes, well, you have to come in and for the taping of this. And I'm like.
Like last minute too.
Last minute too. I'm like, I'm doing something right now. She goes, well, you don't understand. I'm afraid of heights. And I would love to see you in the new top of the fire truck here.
Yeah, but I was trying to like really convince him, you, to come so that you and Andy, our camera guy, our technician, can do it. So at 2 o'clock, I was like, I guess he's not coming. Because like when we got off the phone, I said, well, if you can be there, be there. And I thought, he'll be there. He'll show up.
See, I'm afraid of heights, too. This is why I do this. And I'm working on the bridge right now. Just letting you know.
Yeah, but, so send a woman to do the job.
Always works. Always works for me.
But, and we went up in the fire truck.
So we talked to David Scott. You went up in the fire truck.
Yeah.
Here's some of the footage from that.
Yeah, take a look. And here we are on top of the world. No. All right. We're on top of the town, at least. So, David, the new ladder truck is in. Can you give us some details?
Well, we got delivery of it this morning. We'll have it for here approximately for a week so that we can organize the compartments and see where we have to put the equipment. The company will take it back within a week. They have work still to do on it. Then we send some of our guys over there for 3 or 4 days to do some training for maintenance. We'll have it back by the second week in March. It'll be here. And then we have somebody coming in from out west to certify our members on operations. You need a class 3 license, a heavy operator's license. The truck as it is right now, empty, is 40 tons. That's without the equipment. Mm-hmm. You have to have a certain mindset to operate the vehicle, obviously, with the restrictions on the roads and the little lanes in town. So yeah, a special license is required, plus the certification to be an aerial operator. We can do anything with this. We can go over 100 feet off the side of the truck, off of the road to somebody's house. Our other truck was old. It was 30-something years old, and we weren't able to do what it had originally been intended for it to do because of the age. This here, top of the line, no worries for anything on this. This is the first one in Quebec, this truck, a custom. It's all electronic display in the cab. There's no more buttons. It's all push on a screen. The ladder itself, the aerial section here, is what's called a hot dip galvanized. This whole aerial section was dumped by a crane into a giant tub, and there's holes drilled in it, and the galvanneal went in everywhere. This will last for at least 30 to 40 years, just the ladder itself.
Oh, let's say that there's a big fire in St. Costant and the Kahnawake Fire Brigade is called to help. Do they have to pay to use the truck from Kahnawake?
No, we have a mutual aid that's based, a pure mutual aid. It's an agreement, a gentleman's agreement, a handshake. If they need our help, we will go help them. If we need their help, they will come help us. There's no charge, no cost for us. This is here for the community first and foremost. Yeah. We're looking to have maybe what's called a wet down, a blessing for the truck, a barbecue, and a thank you will be coming up for the community, for sure.
Yeah. Hopefully we can get on the ground in a few minutes. But once again, to all the community members and everybody else who helped fundraise, the ladder truck is finally here. Yeah.